Welcome back, fellow makers. Today we are going to dive into an exciting realm of task automation with our ESP32. Imagine a device performing specific action on its own. Now, there might be a few who have worked with other microcontrollers like Arduino and so on. But for task automation, it's all about letting our ESP32 perform predefined actions at scheduled intervals. It's like having a virtual assistant for your hardware executing without any constant manual intervention. To achieve task automation, we'll introduce a handy library today called as simpletimer.h. It allows us to schedule tasks with precision and simplicity. Now, many of us might say that we could use delay, but with the delay there could be only a few things. It could be a wait, and we had to use that in a loop. But by using a simple timer, we could actually do an intervention without disturbing the other parts of the code. So let's start. So before we go to the code, we'll require the ESP32 and an LED and a breadboard. And to protect the LED, we'll be needing a resistor. So these are all the key components we'll need today. And later we'll be automating another small part. We'll be needing an LDR, a light dependent resistor, and another resistor along with it so that we can have a voltage divider. So these are the components that we will need today, and I'll be providing you with the circuit diagram. So now, in order to get the code, first of all, like I said, we'll need the library, simple timer. So this library link is provided in the description. This is a Git repository. You'll have to just click on code and download zip. Once you download the zip file, you'll have to add this to the Arduino libraries. So you'll have to go to sketch, include library, add zip library, and then locate wherever you have downloaded it. I've downloaded it in the programming guide. So it's going to be here, simple timer, and then as you can see that I already have this simple timer master library already included before. So now, without wasting any more time, let's start typing the code. So in the first case, we will be needing the Wi-Fi library. So I can say Wi-Fi dot it and hash include simple timer. So simple timer dot h. So that's how you can include the simple timer library. And then we have an LED pin, so we'll define an LED pin. So LED pin. And you can define it to be whatever you want. Now, for example, if you have it as 2, this will be the inbuilt LED in case you don't have an LED. Or else we'll be using one of the pins. We'll look into it later. For now, I'm going to use pin number 13. I need to create a simple timer instance. So we'll say simple timer. And then you can call it anything that you want. I'll call it as timer. After that, we'll be defining a LED pin in the mod. It's an output mod. So I'm going to say LED pin, comma, output. This sets the pin as output mod. And now to understand that most of our digital pins on the ESP32 can function in both digital and analog. Most of them, not all, you can actually refer to the pin maps and check their functionalities. Now We need to create a function called as toggle because we are going to just simply look at automating the LED to just blink. Now, most of you might know what is blink, but I'll be calling it as toggle because I'm going to read the status and then do a particular function. So in order to blink, maybe most of you might know that you have to turn it on, then add a delay, then turn it off, then add a delay. But that is to blink. Now in order to toggle, we could simplify this entire thing in just one line of code called as digital write the pin, whatever pin it is. Now we have defined LED pin as the variable, and then say not digital read the pin. So it is going to be set to whatever the pin status is not to. So if it is high, it's going to go to low, and if it is low, it is going to move on to high. So basically it's going to toggle its case from either from high or to low. So far we have made the toggle function. It's a complete function. Now we just need to call it after a particular interval. So now when we need to call it at a particular interval, we are going to define, we need to write the code in the void setup timer.setInterval, and need to define it after how long. I'm going to call it after 2 seconds. 2000 represents 2 seconds, and then the name of the function that we need to call. So if anyone is familiar here with JavaScript, you would definitely know what set interval means. So now we have the function being called, and we need to run the timer in our main loop. So let's say timer dot run, and that is all. You can save your code and then run it. So I will check if the board is connected. Not yet. I'll connect it in the first place. So now I've connected it and it's there on the port. Now you can just click on upload. Now as you can see that our LED is blinking, or actually toggling its case, and this is happening on and on. It's going to go forever since it's in the loop. Now this is a very simple task that I wanted you to know, and since we have got hands-on with the timer, we are now going to get the LDR in the picture, where we are going to read the sensor reading, and then based on the sensor reading we'll set a threshold, and after the threshold has been crossed, we are going to since if there is more light we'll turn off the LED, and if there's less light we'll turn on the LED. This is a very basic function. I want you to get introduced to the ESP32 with a very simple example. So let's move into the code. So const int LDR pin equal to, let me just have a look at the ESP32. I think I'm going to pick 34. So 34. I've chosen 34 since it's on the same side of the ESP32 for me. Okay, your model could be different, so you could pick a different pin whenever needed. Now once that is done, we need to configure the pin mode. Since it's a sensor, the LDR pin is going to be an input pin. Now so far everything has been done. Now it's time to call our other function. Now This is a very good practice of calling everything in parts of sensors, I mean in parts of functions, because that keeps your code very clean. Now the basic steps are to read the sensor here, then we need to set the threshold. If I mean sensor reading is greater, then turn off the LED, and if sensor reading is lesser, then turn on the LED. So basically these are the parts. If the reading is less than the threshold, we'll turn on the LED. Okay, so these are the parts, and let's start reading it. So the first will be, let's call it as LDR value, because we need to store it in another variable. Analog read, the pin is LDR pin, and then we need to set the threshold. So let's set the threshold to be, let's say 500. You can change this threshold based on your environment or the ambience of light. Now it'll vary for all of us. So I'll say if LDR value is greater than the threshold, then we will say digital write LED pin to be low, and then we do not need to specify this because there are only two cases, just low and high. So I'm just going to say else digital write LED pin high. So I mean these are the only two parts. Now in case if you want to be on a safer side and you want and you cannot figure out why, you know, your sensor is not working as per you expect it to work, and so it's always a good practice to introduce a serial monitor in the picture whenever you're learning something new. So in the void setup, I'm going to write serial.begin, which is going to initiate the serial connection. So I'll say 115200, that's the baud rate at what I'm going to set it. So serial, let's print the LDR value so that we know what exactly it is doing or what is the value. So I'll say sensor reading and then serial dot print on a new line, and here I'll print the LDR value. So LDR value, so I think this LDR value is enough. And in case if you want to print even the status, you can actually say low, and you could actually say high. So that's all. Don't forget the semicolons. This is all that is done. After that, we need to set the interval for, I'm not going to use this toggle anymore. So let's use a function called as read sensor. So I'll write read sensor here. So now our read sensor function is going to work after every 2 seconds. So let's first compile it and check if there are any errors, and then we'll upload it. We'll go and check the ESP32. Now I've done the connections. The connections again will be provided in the description with a link. So let's see whether it works. So now so far, I do not know what are the readings that are being read, whether the LDR is giving the right pins. Now it is completely non-functional. Alright, so how to tackle this case? We are going to go and have a look. Serial monitor. So the reading here, the readings here are 2635. Now I'll cover this. I'm actually covering it in the background, covering the LDR with my finger. So when I am doing that, my readings are 9 to set the threshold accordingly. And so we are going to set the threshold to around, let's say around 1000, or let's say 1200. And re-upload the code. Try to cover it. So still, I need to look at the connections. I'll have a look at the serial monitor. So well, you can see that it has an interval of every 2 seconds. So now I have turned it close to, the reading is close to 800, so it's going to remain in the high state, and once I take my finger off, it's going to turn off. So it means, it says that there is sufficient light. So you can feel free to experiment with different intervals and actions. Automation opens up endless possibilities. Now in the next part of the video segments, we are going to talk about executing specific actions. And we'll be learning hands-on with the simple timer again. And we'll move on to, we will be moving on to parts where we'll be using complex sensors.